Rahul Gandhi, while addressing the media in Manipur on Monday, 8th of July, said that Manipur is one of the most beautiful states of the Indian Union. Well, Manipur indeed is one of the most beautiful states, but of India, as a nation, a country, not just a union of states. Rahul Gandhi, ahead of the 2024 elections, during his various foreign visits ad nauseam, repeated the rhetoric that India is a union of states and not really a nation, a country. Well, it is indeed true that the Article 1 of the Constitution of India says that India, that is Bharat, is a union of states. However, the preamble to the Constitution does mention India as a nation. However, Bharat as a civilization has existed for centuries as one of the oldest living civilizations of the world. And nations make constitutions, not the other way around. Well, you refuse to accept India as a country or as a nation, but keep on repeating it as a union of states, you are essentially trying to erase the civilizational history of India. Rahul Gandhi has been referring to India as a union of states for over 2 years now. While speaking in the parliament on the motion of thanks to the president's address in Lok Sabha, in February 2022, Congress MP Rahul Gandhi had claimed that India was just a union of states and not as a nation. India is described in the Indian Constitution as a union of states and not a nation. One cannot rule over the people of a state in India. Different languages and cultures cannot be suppressed. It is a partnership, not a kingdom, Rahul Gandhi had said. Back then, he insisted that the dynamics between state and centre are that of negotiation and insinuated that India does not quite have a single identity, that states are separate entities and part of India like how various European countries are part of the European Union. While India as a political entity came into being on 15th of August 1947, it has been one of the oldest and continuously inhabited civilizations of the world. To say India did not exist prior to 15th August 1947 is nothing but intellectual dishonesty. Let us now talk about the Indian Constitution which Rahul Gandhi is waving and swearing by these days. So the drafting committee of a constitution was very careful in choosing the words. There is a reason they chose Union of States and not Federation of States to describe India as a country, since union as a term better defines relations between various states among themselves as well as the central government. It is not that the states were separate, distinct entities that came together and are bound by a contract. These states or group of states cannot quite secede from the union and cannot quite change the borders of their own states at their own free will. Hence, India is a union of states and not federation of states. Now that we have it out of our way, let us understand what the chairman of drafting committee of a constitution, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, had to say about union of states. Dr. Ambedkar had very clearly said that Indian states cannot be further divided only for convenience of administration and that the country is an integral whole. Not just Dr. Ambedkar, but even Rahul Gandhi's great-grandfather and first Prime Minister of independent India, Jawaharlal Nehru, has many times mentioned that the organization of princely states and provinces were not just on linguistic lines, but also from the point of administrative efficiency. But bringing the term Union of States to refer to India as a country, Rahul Gandhi appears to be fueling subnationalism, which is not too surprising, since during his election campaign, he did not quite let go of any opportunity to pit one state against the other. Whether it was posturing Amol versus Nandini to pit Gujarat against Karnataka or Assam versus Gujarat by telling people in Assam how Gujaratis are taking away their money. By regularly flaring up regionalism sentiments, Rahul Gandhi has tried to flare up subnationalism, where the state identity becomes bigger than their identity as an Indian, thereby slowly driving them away from them being an Indian. This, along with the caste divide Rahul Gandhi has been fueling, it is nothing but targeting to create an extremely fragmented Indian society where instead of cooperation, everyone distrusts the other. That way, instead of progressing as a whole, Indians can continue fighting amongst themselves, a dream come true for those who want to destroy India's nationalism. From North versus South divide to caste politics to religious appeasement to fueling subnationalism, Rahul Gandhi seems to be doing everything he can to polarize India so much that it again becomes easier for so-called colonial masters to rule on us. As they say, Angrez chale gaye, brown sepoys chhod gaye. Let us know what do you think about Rahul Gandhi and his divisive politics in comments below.